The HealthBeat Show, sponsored by Watson Wellness Water. Your health is your wealth.
And welcome to this week's special version of the HealthBeat Show. I'm Dr. Jeffrey Watson. We're talking about the health of our young people, and we are talking with one of the greatest influences, certainly from the Bay and maybe in the world as it comes to music. You know, when we talk about public health, we talk about all the issues that are going on with young people. African Americans are the only group that have homicide in the top five causes of death in our community. So what kind of things can we do to change our health in this community? Factors like eating right, factors like get enough rest, factors like being involved with music, being involved with exercise, with sports, with church, with prayer, meditation, things like this. That's what we're here talking about today, and we're talking with none other than the wonderful Dwayne Wiggins, who was one of the founders of the Tony, and then sitting next to me, I'm very fortunate to be with my lovely daughter, Angela Watson, and you will also see some other wonderful young folks, R&B, Richard and Bina, and Brian Watson. So, Dwayne, first of all, it's an honor to be here with you. And, you know, we're talking about young people and trying to change their lives and trying to make them healthy. And some of the artistic influences, you know, health is a state of psychological, spiritual, physical states of well-being and not simply the absence of disease. So if you can get into some kind of venue that's going to make you think right psychologically, also some of the physical aspects that are good, and many of the things that you've talked about over and over, you've been involved in, you probably don't realize that I know that you've been involved in venues where you made sure that condoms were given out. That you had a mission such that there was safe sex, particularly at the height of the HIV epidemic here in the Bay Area. So, one, tell us just a little bit about yourself, your background, coming up here in Oakland. Where'd you go to high school? And was there anybody in your school that was a major influence on you?
Well, I was born in London. I want to hear you. I couldn't even hold a straight face. No, I was born and raised in Oakland. Woo! The blessing and the curse. No, it's nothing but a blessing. And I'm an Aquarius, so you know that made things flow easy. Mm-hmm. But my high school was Castlemont. Actually, everybody in my family's high school, I got, you know, seven siblings, and
it's an old all of us, school.
Castlemont, yes, yeah. It's great for us, man. To me, Castlemont was like how Oakland School of the Arts was, because a lot of the programs that I see that happen in Oakland School of the Arts, it was in public schools back then. So we learned our trades and crafts and everything like that in high school. You know, even carpentry, electrical, everything else, so.
They don't have all that as much anymore in all the major high schools.
No. Well, no, not like they used to. It was mandatory back then.
Yeah. And I remember we talked about this offline, a great man by the name of Phil Reeder.
Phil Reeder
was the minister of music at our church by the side of the road.
You did mention it. Right. Yeah. I've been there before.
You have?
Yes.
Okay. Well, come again.
Well, I'll tell you, man, Phil Reeder really laid out a lot of stuff that we still, B, Raphael, all of us, we still keep that stuff into our regiment of music.
The spirituality, too.
Definitely, you got to connect there first. You know what I mean? It's all about the spirit. You got to be in the right spirit to create anything. That's how our music was created, because, like I said, we didn't know how to really write. We just let it come. And mm-hmm. come later on, we listen like, man, that's cool. That was that, whatever you want.
That's
you,
us.
You know what I mean? So yeah, our music is that connection. But this is beautiful to know that, you know, you're coming out of Oakland School of the Arts, and you're on your way to Paris and all over the world, and you're about to take Oakland all over the world. That is a big venture, young lady.
Thank you.
In ballet.
Yes, thank you very much.
Whoa, Oakland is so rich, you know? Mm-hmm. Just the soil itself, just the sense of pride you have. I know there's a lot of new people here coming here, and they even feel the pride about us. But we got to give them the history, and we got to continue on. And you are doing that, exactly. But you come from good, you know, you got a momager. Assistant.
It's important to have the right support, to have a good mindset and the right support. You know, things don't just, Dwayne didn't just pop up to be Grammy platinum winning artist. I mean, the steps had to occur. Mm-hmm. How did you get started just dancing?
One day I knew I wanted to go to OSA. I was in elementary school and I was thinking, where am I going next? I have no idea where I'm going. And Richard, my brother, first made the decision that he wanted to go to an art school. So we looked at Oakland School for the Arts, and we looked at the board and we looked at the different emphases. Richard decided to go to vocal, and I still didn't know where I was going. So I was looking down at the different categories, and I got to the bottom and it said dance. And I scrolled all the way down and it said, it's the hardest emphasis and anybody who does it will like find a new like form of work, like grow a new work ethic. So I was like, I'm gonna prove that to myself. I'm gonna audition for dance. That's what I'm gonna do. I took the audition and it was the worst thing in the universe. It was the hardest thing I've ever done. To this day, there's still hard things, but that was one of the hardest. And then I went back to elementary school, and then a few weeks went by, and I was in a music class with Richie, and Mom burst in the door, and she said, you have a dance class. They asked you to come and take dance. So my first class, and that was I took my first class at OSA, and that was the worst thing in the universe. And then after that, I just kept going because I wanted to prove to myself that I could do it. And then after that, I got into the school. I started looking at like ballet companies. I was like, I want to do this for real. Like, I want more people to know me. Like, I want to get myself out there. So the first step to that was summer intensives. So I auditioned for San Francisco Ballet, and that was the scariest audition ever. And I got in on full scholarship for the summer intensive. And after that, I auditioned for the school for San Francisco Ballet, and I got in.
Those kind of remind me of the steps that you've talked about that you went through.
You know,
you went to the school, you started working outside, and then growing.
When you tell the story of how you got into dance, I really can feel that, because the way I got into music, I played on the streets, of course, playing the blues and jamming Jimi Hendrix and all that, but I didn't know how to read. And so when I went to Castlemont, I almost got put out of Castlemont. Now, how do you get put out of Castlemont? Those are a little rough, you know, rough edges. But I got stuck in the locker, you know, cutting class, listening to the band, and got in there, was hid in the tuba locker, and then my buddy locked me. My buddy. Locked me in there.
Locked in the locker?
Sitting in this position the whole day. Listen, about 4 o'clock, I bust the door open and the teacher was standing there right there, like, wait the whole day. Like, he said, I'm gonna kick your butt. And he was like, he pulled me in the room and he said, what you doing in there? You just bust the door. And I was like, I was listening to the music. You don't even play no instrument. You sitting in here. I said, I do. I play guitar. He said, you don't play no damn guitar. I said, yes, I do. The teachers could talk to you like that. Mm. And they could smack you too. Oh. Let you know. Yes. But anyway, so that happened, and he said, I'm going to bring this guitar, and if you don't play this guitar, I'm going to beat your butt. He didn't even say the word but. He gave me that guitar, and I started playing. And he just looked at me, he's like, how come you're not in music class? I said, I don't know how to read. And that's how I got into music. Wait, no, I stopped messing up, you know what I mean?
Angela left one piece out that I thought was interesting. She, while Richie was playing football, she became the cheerleader on the Pop Warner football team when she was about 5 years old. And she began dancing, really, as a cheerleader. And that, she got good at it. And I also have to say, she can sing pretty good, too. But she did the dancing and the singing, and then that, I think, prepared her, like you playing on the street and with your friends and so on, prepared you to move up to the next level.
Oh, yeah. The things that you learn in Oakland and the hardships and all that, when you're out on the road, you're gonna thank for the lessons you got here, because it prepares you for the world.
Right.
You know, when you're moving around in different countries, when you see something funky, you know how to get out of the way. Other people be goofy looking and you know, you're from Oakland. That skill comes in. You're gonna thank the town for that.
Because I've been to a lot of summer intensives, and I feel like there are not a lot of people from color or like the diversity that Oakland has.
Yes.
So when I first went to San Francisco Ballet, I was crying because nobody looked like me. Everybody was just like, everything was whitewashed, like everything. There were a lot of like French teachers, like beautiful blonde haired, blue eyed, beautiful skinny little girls.
Yeah.
And everybody would ask me where I was from, because I would have to like focus on myself to get out of that like destructive mindset of self-comparison, which is a great thing for mental health. That's the first step for mental health, too.
That's key.
Self-comparison.
You can build no confidence up in the town, for real.
Yeah.
Self-comparison is a very destructive concept.
It is, huh?
Yeah. So.
See, folks, I'm learning from the youngsters. Like, what are you
talking
about?
I know. I'm telling you. You hear health is a psychological, spiritual, socioeconomic, and physical. We always just think physical.
Yes.
But mental health is such a key thing.
Yes. Yeah.
And then since you said something real important. You looked around, there was nobody black.
Yeah.
Who was your idol then as a dancer?
Well, of course, Misty Copeland. Like as a dancer, it was Misty Copeland, but the main person I had to think about was my mom, because she she got me through the whole like a process of like just nobody else looked like me, so I had to find something within, so something more important. And she looked exactly like me, well, basically. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
See?
There you go.
She was trying to make you ready for Hammer. That was something.
And
she took the dance thing to
Mom has taught me a lot of stuff about ballet, too, about, for instance, the school that you're getting ready to go to in Paris was one of the first ballet schools. Is that right, Mom?
Founded by King Louis XIV of France, discovered classical ballet. And 300 years ago.
Founded by King Louis the
King Louis the 14th
of France.
Yeah.
Founded by.
Yes, it wasn't
all-man school.
All-man school?
Yeah, it was, founded by men. And then,
all the choreography was by a man. And he got with a classical music artist, and they created dance and music together 300 years ago.
So when you given all that information about, you know, where you're about to travel and, and such, do you, that's the prep and the setup. You got to, you know, get a little information about where you're traveling.
Or, right.
A lot of people don't know. You got to, even just as simple as, you got to know what the temperature is like.
Yes.
So that you can pack the right clothes.
Absolutely.
Yeah, that's the prep and the setup.
Mm-hmm.
Man, but you I'm honored to meet you, young lady. This is, you dope.
The HealthBeat Show, sponsored by Watson Wellness Water. Your health is your wealth.
When I was six, my days were spent playing basketball. When I was six, my dream was to make it to the NBA. When I was six, my mom had a stroke.
I'm Paul George, and I want you to spot a stroke fast.
F, face drooping. A, arm weakness. S, speech difficulty. T, time to call 911.
Protect the ones you love.
Spot a stroke fast.
Well, Thomas, you've got prediabetes. But with more exercise and a change in diet, it can be reversed.
I've tried exercising. It just makes me hungry for bacon.
I love bacon, too. And who really likes to exercise?
Not me.
Me neither.
Nobody. So we're good?
What? Oh, you still have prediabetes. Big time.
The AAWP Medical Minute is sponsored by the African American Wellness Project.
Our series on improving brain function and reducing the risk of Alzheimer's continues. I'm Dr. Mike Lenore with the AAWP Medical Minute. Three areas for optimism in controlling Alzheimer's include diet, medication, and exercise to reduce hypertension. Today we focus on diet. Claims about diets for brain health are plentiful, and recently researchers found that extra virgin olive oil helps stave off Alzheimer's, at least in mice. Those fed a diet enriched in extra virgin olive oil could learn and remember better than those not fed the diet. And while the panel did not find evidence to recommend any specific diet, those diets that included whole grains, fruits, vegetables, low-fat dairy, and keeping salt down deserve more study. Our next segment will focus on medications available. AAWP Medical Minute is supported by the Dan Weinstein Family Fund.
If you have a business, product, or service and would like to advertise on HealthBeat, contact us. We feature affordable advertising for small, growing, and established businesses. Reach an accessible audience to over 4 million viewers. Promote the health and wealth of your business and give us a shot.
For advertising and sponsorship opportunities, log on to healthbeattv.info.
Yeah, I take a lot of pride in saying that I was like that. I'm from Oakland. Like I said, the summer intensives, everybody would be like, "I'm from France. I'm from," and I'd be like, "I'm from Oakland." Like,
you gotta put an accent.
I'm
here.
I'm from the town.
Oh shit! You should put an accent on it.
Yeah.
Oakland. Americans. Going to the Paris Upper Ballet in the summer.
Really?
Only
over 200.
Only five or six Americans.
Five or six Americans out of 200 are attending.
Yeah. Yes. Yeah.
And you're one of the five.
Yes.
Or six.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yes.
And the other important thing is just like a lot of music.
That's big when she said full scholarship. But look,
just like a lot of music today comes from African roots. Comes from black roots. Mm-hmm. Some of the, particularly I just went to see Angela dance, there were so many moves, there even the drums and so on, like you all have here, that I could see where the evolution of some of the dance moves come from.
Yes. Oh yes.
Yeah.
Really?
That being Africa. Yeah.
Is that on your agenda at all?
Africa. Yeah.
You gotta hit South Africa.
When she first met Mrs. Coleman, but Angela became an ambassador of the Guguluthum Foundation, which is an African organization that takes dancers from America and around the world to Africa.
Did you say Google?
Guguluthum Foundation.
Is that like Google on the African term?
Yeah.
I've been seeing a lot of people like I was in Ghana. And Google has a pretty heavy presence in, with our people over there.
Is that
like, this is hot, yeah. Yeah, this is good.
Okay. Well, good she did. Right, she did get to meet the great Misty Copeland, too.
Yeah.
And they exchanged autographs, which was just a really beautiful thing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Get ready.
But we want to say that we really appreciate you for being a leader in the community, for working with the young people in the community, for giving back. You know, there's so many times that you give back. You let and invited Richard and Bina to come up on the stage and sing with you. That was had to be one of the biggest things in life. Young people, if we're going to survive with our young people, we have to look to people like yourself who will reach out and give them opportunities, give them support so that they can have good mental health, good physical health, good spiritual health.
From the time I met Richard and Bina, I noticed, I was like, they are pretty groomed. They're pretty professional in learning, knowing who they are and what they came to do. They were focused. And when you were telling me about some of the instructors who they came up around, I was like, oh yeah, that's like a little bit, that's some Phil Reader type of stuff. No wonder they were groomed like that. So I respect, and I want to say thank you for allowing me to learn. It's still a learning process for me. Mm-hmm. Every day.
Yeah, along with, I'm glad you brought that up, along with one of the great people is Mr. Reginald Savage, was at Oakland School of the Arts.
I meant to say that.
Who really he took a great responsibility in supporting and pushing Angela. So
that
we appreciate him as well as all of those who have been a part of it. And certainly Mrs. Carolyn Watts and all the hard work she does for these young folks.
Takes a village.
Takes a village to raise a child.
That's right.
So they say it's a man's world? I don't see anybody's name on it.
While they were doing their thing, we slowly changed all that.
Today, women can do anything men can do. And there's one thing we're even better at.
I'm Dr. Jeffrey Watson, and you should know your numbers. A lot of people don't know what high blood pressure usually is. Any number above 140 on the top number and above 90 on the bottom number is considered phase one of hypertension. If your blood pressure is above 160 on the top number and 100 on the bottom number, that's phase two of hypertension. Now, African Americans make up about 12% of the U.S. population, but they make up greater than 30% of all people with high blood pressure. High blood pressure is associated with heart attacks, it's associated with strokes, and it is taking us out at a disproportionate amount. Make sure that you keep a low sodium diet. In other words, don't sprinkle any salt on your food and look on the boxes, look on the cans, take in less than 2 grams of salt a day. Keep your weight down and try to keep that stress down. Go for walks, go for jogging, and try to meditate and think about those things that are bringing you stress and try to take those away. High blood pressure is thought to be a silent killer, but if you have pounding in your head, if you're feeling dizzy, if you feel tense, if you are fatigued, or you have palpitations in your chest, these may be signs and symptoms of high blood pressure. Talk to your doctor about it. I always say that if you knew better, you could do better. I'm Dr. Jeffrey Watson, and remember always that your health is your wealth, and when you have your health, you have everything. I'll see you next time. All right. Well, we're right here on the HealthBeat Show, special edition. What can we do to help our young people? Certainly exercise, food, diet, but also getting involved with music, getting involved with dance. I'm Dr. Jeffrey Watson, right here with Dwayne Wiggins and Angela Watson. Remember always that your health is your wealth, and when you have your health, you have everything. See you next time. I'm Dr. Jeffrey Watson. Thanks for being with us on this episode of the HealthBeat Show, where we try to educate you about different aspects of healthcare, about eating right, exercising right, what you can do to help yourself, how to access the healthcare system, what kind of questions to ask, what you should do for any particular disease state. Because I always believe that your health is your wealth. And when you have your health, you have everything. I'm Dr. Jeffrey Watson. We'll see you next time.
Bye.